after the next sunrise, here's Joe getting ready to go out with the MMU.
We have a sequence of footage now that are drawn from both the EVAs, interspersed. We won't distinguish between the two, but try to give you a flavor for what it was like. Rick says, right at sunrise, we went out. Dale's actually flying out here with Rick recording most of this on all sorts of film. About this time, I thought that he should think twice about it, but Dale, go ahead and describe.
Joe had done this on flight day five and had proven that the MMU and the Stinger concept for capturing the satellite worked, in fact, worked perfectly. And I essentially had just a lot of fun on flight day seven. No, on flight day seven, no, it all worked. There was, it took a big load off my mind. Because I flew out a little bit differently than Joe had. You might remember Joe commenting that the sun had bothered him. It was in his eyes during the last phase. And you'll see here in a minute that when the sun finally does come up, I was fortunate enough to use the orbiter's nose to shadow the sun. So my approach to the satellite, and you can see that the shadow of the nose of the orbiter now is on the satellite and on me. And so my docking was a little bit easier with that information that Joe had given me from the earlier EVA. MMUs perform flawlessly, as you heard us talk about from space. And this method of capturing the satellite certainly worked well. And
you can see the arm in the lower right corner of the picture, which was a position that Anna had put it in to assist in our station-keeping task.
Notice that the people who brought that satellite to us left it in absolutely perfect position with regard to its rotation and lack of nutation, which we appreciated.
We can't emphasize that enough. The satellite originally was rotating 50 revolutions per minute, but was slowed down by ground controllers very painstakingly over many, many weeks' time. Positioned and slowed down. And in the slowing, they left it still turning at a very, very regular rate. So it made our job absolutely easy as pie. Once docked, the procedure then was to use the MMU to stop the rotation, which was equally easy. You can see it's now quite stable, and the MMU pilot could then maneuver the satellite, turn it wherever we wanted it in such a way that Anna could grab the grapple fixture.
Yeah, this is a sequence from the first rendezvous, and it worked just like it did in the simulator, getting Joe commands to maneuver it such that I could see the end effector, the grapple target, and it went very well, very smoothly.